It's music from the Waterboys. That is the title track to the album, This Is the Sea. Patti Smith right before that with Dancing Barefoot. Johnny Cash covering local artist Soundgarden's Rusty Cage, and started off the set with music from the Easy Beats, Friday on My Mind, here on the afternoon show. Kevin Cole here with you. I'm down in the performance space and just thrilled to be joined by just an amazing songwriter, Mr. Paul Kelly. Welcome to KEXP, or welcome back, I should say.
Well, thank you. That's a very nice welcome, and that's a very nice set of music to follow up.
Nice. Well, I was trying to think of what I thought would be a good lead-in to your performance. Now, you did a sold-out show last night at the Triple Door. How was it?
Oh, it was really good, yeah. So I've played there a few times before, and it's a beautiful place to play. It sounds good. And
yeah, it's a great space.
Yeah, it was a fun show.
Good Seattle crowd?
Yeah, they were great.
Good. Well, how about a couple songs, and then we can chat a little bit?
Yeah, I'll just introduce these couple of songs. The new record I've got out is called Spring and Fall, and it's a song cycle, which means that it tells a story from beginning to end. So what I thought I would play today is a few songs from that record in the order in which they appear, so as to give you the gist of the arc of the story. So I'll start with the third song on the record and move into the one straight after it. So we're starting in the spring summer part of the record, and then moving into a couple of turning points.
Some stuff has already happened.
This is for the ages. Darling, you're one for the ages. I'm glad you live here in mine. Your face and figure belong to centuries been and gone, those Renaissance and Roman times. Darling, you're one for the ages. Long may you live in my rhyme. The years will cut us down, but they won't keep us in the ground. Out of the grave we'll climb. Ooh, darling, you're one for the ages. You'll never go out of style. You walked into the ball dressed by Saint Vincent de Paul, with that shy and serious smile. For the ages, your beauty suits every clime. There's a mystery deep within, and in the light upon your skin, I could study for all time. Ooh, darling, you're one for the ages. 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 Next song, which follows on straight on from that, gonna be good. We're kind of at the just after the high point, I guess, and moving into the turn to fall. I'm gonna be good from now on. I'm gonna be good. I'm gonna be good from now on. I'm gonna be good. I wrote a list, I thought it best. of all that must apply. I wrote a list, it didn't take long. I'm gonna be good from now on. I'm gonna be good. I'm gonna be good from now on. I'm gonna be good. My sweet brothers, my sisters all, they're standing by. They've been delighted, they've been appalled. I'm gonna be good from now on. I'm gonna be good. Like Big John says in his song, you gotta walk the line. The line is narrow, the line is long. I'm gonna be good from now on. I'm gonna be good. I'm gonna do right from now on. I'm gonna do right. I'm gonna be good from now on. I'm gonna do right.
Paul Kelly live on the afternoon show. Gonna be good and For the Ages, two songs from the new record, Spring and Fall. I love Gonna Be Good. Just, I think we all have that that voice running in the back of our heads, kind of saying that.
Yeah. It's interesting because you played Johnny Cash before in the set before, and of course that song references I Walk the Line, which I always thought was really interesting song, because on one level he's espousing, you know, true love and fidelity and walking the line. But that song keeps changing keys. It's really interesting. It keeps changing the keys. Like, sort of like someone clearing their throat when they're just about to, you know, tell a lie.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. Yeah, I love the way he sort of hums too, to try and find the key.
Yeah, yeah. It's almost someone rehearsing a speech, as if he's come home late at night and he's coming in, he's trying to work out what to say when he gets in.
Yeah, yeah. So Spring and Fall, your 19th album, does that surprise you?
No, not really, because I can count. I've been making records for a long time, and they just add up after a while.
Yeah, yeah. And some of the songs on this record date back to about 5 years, from what I've read at least, to the last album. So Stolen Apples, which I think came out in 2007.
That's right.
When did you realize it was a song cycle and kind of a concept record?
Fairly early on, I had a couple of songs that had been sort of lying around for a while. I didn't write many songs between Stolen Apples and this, because I was involved writing a book, and which took up most of 2.5 years. But I had a song that sort of suggested the beginning of a relationship, and that feeling of things are new and fantastic. I'd also written this fairly dark, leave-taking song, and they seem to be sort of really polar opposites of each other. So once I had those two, I had those two poles, and that's, I guess, when the idea took hold to maybe try and link them up with other songs. And I had a couple of sort of hinge songs. Gonna Be Good's almost like on the sort of a hinge song. So I had it's like I had the spine of a story there, and I just had to fill in the ribs or to flesh it out.
Do you think that way typically when you approach an album? Like, how do all the pieces fit together and use that as sort of a challenge to write more material to fit within that concept?
It's similar to the way most records come together for me. I think probably for a lot of artists too. It's when you start to get a few songs that seem to somehow, they start talking to each other or having some relation to each other, and that sort of helps you move on and write the rest. I think all artists try to have their albums be coherent in some way, and take care with the order and so on. So doing this, turning this record into really one long story was really just pushing that idea a bit further.
I understand that last night at the show you actually played the album front to back. Had you done that before?
No, that was the first time. We finished the record July last year. It came out in Australia in October. But we haven't toured it there yet. We're going to tour this year. So I haven't really been doing any gigs. I'm planning to, when we do go out on the road, that we'll play that record straight through as the first half of the show, and then do old songs in the second half. So I finally plucked up the courage to try and do it all on my own last night.
Now, when you say the courage, is that because you know or you think that you'll be kind of playing a lot of unfamiliar material to an audience right away, or just...
I wasn't so much worried about that because it's a fairly short set. One of the things I was conscious of with this record was to make the songs very short and succinct. So the record's a really old-fashioned record in that it's 36 minutes long. And the whole idea of, again, the song cycle and telling a story, making the record one long story, is to keep it moving. So sparse instrumentation, not a lot of instrumental passages, and trying to just make every word count. So I knew that if I set it up properly with the audience, that say, oh, we're just going to play, it's going to be, 35 to 40 minutes, and then we'll get into, some older songs. So I wasn't so much worried about that, but it was actually playing, even though it is a sparse record, my nephew Dan Kelly, who I made it with, is sort of a big, big part of it. So just getting, and we'll be coming back, I'll be coming back in the spring with him. So we'll be able to play it. I'll have all the colours of Dan with me.
Yeah.
It's just a little bit scary at first doing it all on your own.
It's Paul Kelly live on the afternoon show. Playing tomorrow night in San Francisco at Café du Nord, and then I think a couple more dates in North America before heading back to Australia for what looked like a pretty rigorous month of touring with Neil Finn.
Yes, we've got a month of tours, month of shows just around Australia with Neil Finn. It's just the window that we had, so we unfortunately can't take it anywhere else at the moment, but that's going to be pretty interesting because we're just combining, we're just in each other's, we're just making one band out of
oh, cool.
Me, Neil, again my nephew Dan, Neil's son Elroy on drums, so it's a family band, and woman Zoe Hopeman on bass. So, and we've picked about 30 songs, 15 each to do, and we're sort of all doing our homework at the moment before we get together for rehearsals.
So you're both going to be on stage at the same time,
yeah,
and kind of maybe sing with each other.
Oh, yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
cool.
Yeah, we sing, we've got verses that we're going to be trading verses in songs and, singing harmonies with each other and,
cool.
And playing with each other. Yeah.
Very cool. It's Paul Kelly live on the afternoon show. Do you mind hopping back into the song cycle where things start getting a little darker?
Yeah, this is the we're sort of past the fall part of the record. We're into winter. This is song number 8 out of 11. It's called Cold as Canada. Morning comes creeping in like a sick and pale child. She leaves in there sleeping in. No good way to say goodbye. She turns her face to the sun. She doesn't have tears to cry. She wonders what on earth she's done. No good way to say goodbye. Out of the eater, something to eat. Out of the strong, something sweet. She's out of shelter. She's as cold as Canada. She gives herself a talking to keep the blood in her eye. She knows what she needs to do. No good way to say goodbye. Cold as Canada. What she needs she cannot buy. I'll do what you can for her. No good way to say goodbye. She's cold as Canada. She's cold as Canada. She's cold as Canada.
It's Paul Kelly live on KEXP, Cold as Canada. Beautiful song from Spring and Fall.
And we'll go to the very last song on the record, which is like the aftermath song. Imagine it taking place maybe quite a bit of time after the events of the rest of the record. It's called Little Aches and Pains. Thanks for your letter, your calm words of comfort. It's good to hear from you again. I'm going okay, taking it day by day. You know what they say, can't complain. It's just these little aches and pains. I got them always now, sunshine or rain. It must be nice up there on the river. Maybe I could visit, haven't had a trip in a while. There's nothing much keeping me here. I see the gang maybe once or twice a year. You and me, we could walk a rambling country mile. Test out these little aches and pains. When all else goes, they remain. Disabled we're born, disabled we die. Is that a cliche? I'll make it one. I hope it doesn't get too creaky. I have found that what you don't know will hurt you. What doesn't kill you makes you weaker. Leaves you with little aches and pains. I got them always now, sunshine or rain. Ooh, the these little aches and pains. I don't count my losses now, just my gains.
Beautiful. Paul Kelly with Little Aches and Pains from the new album Spring and Fall. And when I first heard the album, the first couple times I heard it, I actually didn't listen to it front to back and hadn't heard anything about it. So I didn't know there was a story necessarily. And so songs would jump out to me or jump out, you know, like Gonna Be Good and just certain ones and certain hooks stuck. But when I heard that song, Little Aches and Pains, I was like, oh, yeah, I can relate. This is, you know, you know, kind of about the body. You get a little older and you got your little aches and pains. And then I had one of those great epiphany moments when you really can get into music on a different level, right? When I actually listened to the record front to back and could connect all the songs and realize, wait a minute, you know, this isn't really about that. This is about more like looking back at relationships and your life and the aches and pains that that maybe your body isn't feeling. But your soul is.
Yeah, well, you know, you try to write songs that can mean all sorts of things. I come from a big family. There's eight of us, and I'm number five. So I got older siblings, and we now have the 5 minute rule when we get together, which is we're only allowed 5 minutes to talk about our medical ailments. Used to be 5 minutes. Now it's 5 minutes each.
Yeah. So you're an incredibly prolific songwriter, and I think a lot of people assume because somebody writes a lot of music that they must listen to or like music.
That's true, yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Is that the case for you?
Yeah.
I know you're a great reader, too. You like reading a lot. Do you prefer reading or sitting around listening to music? Can you do both at the same
both.
Time?
I can't do both at the same time. I got to do one or the other. Yeah, I love words. I like poetry. I like fiction. I try. You know, I tend to read more on tour than at home because at home, sort of, there's always things taking up your time. But touring is probably when I do my most reading because there's so much. You know, as Charlie Watts said, playing for the Rolling Stones, most of the time being in a band is waiting around. So, I'm lucky to be able to read in a moving vehicle. Otherwise, I don't know how I would have got around all this touring.
Any good new books you'd recommend?
I've been reading old books, so I've been. I'm trying to think of a more recent book that I read because all I've been reading is I've been reading Ovid, which is pretty old. Remembrance of Things Past by Proust, which is a book, a big long book I read when I was much younger, and I'm rereading that at the moment. My mind's gone blank. Things just sort of cross my path, and I read them and pass them on.
Yeah, yeah. So a couple nights ago, you were in Minneapolis. And I saw on your Facebook page that after your show, you were able to stop by the Dakota Club.
Yes, yeah, very, very, very lucky. Prince was doing three shows there, and this is the third one, and we just found out about it the day we arrived. So
Prince was doing a hometown residency at a small little venue.
Yeah, the Dakota Club. It's a jazz club.
Yep.
And you're from Minneapolis, aren't you?
I am.
Yeah, so you know it.
I've seen him multiple times at First Avenue, and you know, then he got huge and would play the hockey rink or whatever. But for listeners that don't know, this is like a 200-300 capacity room. It's like the triple door.
Yeah, yeah.
And Prince was, what was he doing? Was he just, was he trying out new material? Was he just jamming?
I didn't know a lot of it. I knew some of the songs, but he was, no, it was, he had an all-women band from, three-piece women band plus him. It was Ida on the bass. They all had names that ended in A. Donna on guitar, I think, and Hannah on the drums. They were all awesome players. And Prince was playing mainly guitar. He went over to the piano for a couple of songs. I walked in on I Like It There. So he had lots of audience participation, so he was getting the audience to sing along, which is always great. he was in a pretty good mood, bantering away, you know, finished one song, and at the end of it he said, I got to give myself a clap for that. So it's very relaxed and, you know, very kind of quite jammy, but the band was obviously really well rehearsed, because it would jam and they would sort of break out, but then when there was a change or a bit coming up, they were really tight. They knew exactly what was coming next.
So I know he's pretty spontaneous and he likes to do these sort of one-off gigs, and somebody asked him, well, why didn't he do it at his own place, like Paisley Park, the studios that he's got, and he had said, well, I would have loved to, but I had booked it out to the group Fun, and they were recording there, so he couldn't use his own studio, he went to the Dakota Club.
The man's got to earn a living.
Paul Kelly, live on the afternoon show. Again, thank you so much for taking time out and playing for us today. Appreciate that.
My pleasure. I like to play.
And so should we look for you to come back on this album, back to the U.S., back to Seattle?
We're definitely coming back between April and June. We're doing a 7-week tour of the States, and Seattle's definitely on the list.
Cool. Look forward to that. And again, thank you so much. Sounded wonderful.
Thanks for having me.
It's the Afternoon Show, KEXP, Seattle.